Last time on True Magnum TV.
One tries to be calm. That doesn't always happen.
Oh, that was a good shot.
It's funny how you can go from the top of the world to the bottom real quick.
There's another bull with him, a littler, smaller bull.
I'd say Utah is off to a really good start. This is going to be fun.
People have no idea what's at stake.
Yeah, you know, there's nothing like the confidence you're on.
Hunting season has begun. And these men will put it all on the line for the hunts of a lifetime. This is True Magnum TV.
True Magnum TV is proudly presented by Western Powders, premium shooting and gun care products.
In Zimbabwe, it's day three into a week-long safari, and so far, Rob Dunham and his client, Kirk, have only harvested one of the three species they came for. With a missed shot on a zebra stallion, Rob knows this is a confidence killer.
Let's go check it out. These guys, they can do this all day long.
I felt I hit them good.
Yeah.
After shooting his giant buffalo, Kirk was on top of the world. But right now, he's doubting his abilities, and that's going to cause us some problems.
Concentrate a little harder.
With no sign of the zebra or blood, Rob and his team press on in the 100-degree heat.
No sign of blood, and in this case, it might not be all bad. Maybe bruised feelings. But first, find out if it's the gun or the hunter. Hopefully, it's something we're going to be able to fix.
Zebra. I see him. Right here.
After 5 miles, the local guide spots zebra high on a hill, giving Kirk a second chance at the prize.
Just walking away.
Right now it's looking good, and Kirk needs to hold it together, or else we're in for some awful hard hunting. And that's my job to help him do that. If I have one failed safari, it's my reputation on the line.
Unless it was brush in the way, I was dead on solid.
When I looked, it didn't look like he just spun and moved off.
Unless I hit something, Rob, like brush in between. Could have the zebra jinx, but I felt really good about it. Really good.
There's a lot of reasons why a shot can miss. I mean, there's a lot of brush. We could have bumped the scope. But right now, that miss is messing with Kirk's head. Confidence is everything, and without it, we can kiss this safari goodbye.
See if there's no blood.
The local guides now must track the zebra and search for blood. If found, then Kirk will have to pay for the animal, even if there's no recovery.
It's always nerve-wracking and works on your confidence when you miss, and I hope for Kirk's and the animal's sake that it was a clean miss.
I don't see any blood. No blood?
Let's go, yeah, no.
It's a good time.
I feel good, but.
If you're bearing down on something at 185 yards away and you're not gonna see this kind of brush,
no.
You won't see it even, and that's all it takes. So it's got nothing to do with shooting, that's just brush.
I've gotta do something to rebuild Kirk's confidence. Otherwise, the safari could be at stake.
I was solid on him.
In Utah, a one-week elk hunt is on its final day, and outfitter James Brion, along with his colleague Brady Larson, are pulling out all the stops.
Man, they're going at it up there.
Everyone back home knows I have this coveted tag, one of the best in the country. There's a lot of pressure on me to succeed. I've had 1 week to get my monster. I can't go home empty-handed.
Okay.
Yep. Just up there quite a ways, yeah. Hunting can be hard, but I always seem to get the job done one way or another. I don't quit.
James and Brady have tracked their bull for days from high in the mountains to low in the valley. But the elk is making it less than easy to get a shot off.
I hope it's that other bull pushing them up out of there instead of us. Oh man, now they're a ways off.
We've been chasing this guy nonstop for a week now. He's always just out of reach. Today's my last day, and I can't afford to lose him now.
On the next draw?
Yeah. He's gonna run right back into that other bull if he goes over there, though. All right. That's the thing about these early season hunts. You gotta work hard at it.
This one's getting down to the wire, but I've been here before. It always comes together.
True Magnum TV is brought to you by Cooper Firearms of Montana. Hornady, accurate, deadly, dependable. Eberly Stock, go in light, come out heavy. Prairie King Ranch. Global Rescue. And by Jonas Brothers Taxidermy Studios of New York.
In Tajikistan, high in the mountains, outfitter Bo Morgan leads the hunt for Markhor goats through the rugged and steep canyons.
There's definitely a good population of Markhor in here. We need to make sure it's the right age class, right twist on the horn. We need to take it slow, take our time, make sure it's the right one. I'm looking for the one.
Bo has just opened this area up to foreign hunters, so he has a lot riding on this first hunt.
It's not just about the trophy out here. The monies from this operation goes to the communities and goes to conservation to keep the thing going for years to come.
But after Bo's client John had complications with his luggage at the airport, Bo is hoping to turn this hunt around.
What a spot to be. Next hour or so is that time of day when animals start moving, so that's what we're hoping.
I feel my toes a little bit.
Yeah, you're limited there. But
they're making it okay.
It's better than slip-ons.
Yeah, better than barefoot.
John with his borrowed shoes. His other boots are in his luggage, somewhere in between here and America. It's only 12 time zones. I'm a little nervous about having John here with borrowed equipment. You gotta do what you gotta do. We're just gonna kind of roll through and make it happen.
There's a big ant. Nice old, you see?
Oh yeah,
white job.
Okay. Nice.
Mission. Now I don't see male, but they was running. There is one on the left.
And the group is there.
Mm-hmm. But he saw the male very low.
More below?
Much.
What do you say, Bo?
You gotta put eyes on him before you go making the move.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of country there. Without getting a good look at this Markhor, gotta kind of leave him alone. We'll drop down this other canyon and see if we can spot something here before it gets dark. We're running out of daylight.
Back in Utah, after a week of tracking his bull, James Brion is starting to realize why the elk in this area are the ones to get.
There's some pressure back home about me getting this elk from my colleagues, friends, even some clients. I'm in the elk capital of Utah, and if I can't get a monster here, what does that say about me? I'm getting that elk. I'll go to the last legal minute of shooting light if I have to.
The clock is ticking as James and Brady track closer to their bull, still just out of reach.
Oh, that's our bull. That's our 7-point. He's not supposed to be over there. Oh, what's he doing over there? That's almost impossible. I wonder if that means game over.
It's frustrating to be following a bull and have it show up where it wasn't supposed to be, and you can't get there without spooking it.
Oh, he's going up over the other side.
This bull is not coming to any call today. This is a once-in-a-lifetime hunt. It's time to make something happen.
We'll get him.
Yeah,
we'll get him.
In Tajikistan, Bo Morgan and his team are searching for Markhor in the canyons, hoping to spot a trophy before sundown.
Never know how the day is going to go. We could spot 20 Markhor, nice Markhor, and if it's not the one, we got to keep moving on and adjust our plans as we go.
Catch that? Nice, nice. That's the gray with the more twist.
Good one.
Mm-hmm. It's
very beautiful. No, no, it's a very good one. Marco is complicated.
It's a good twist.
After several days of hard hunting, Bo has his sights on the perfect billy.
We'll let the hunter look. Let him look. Chasing her a circle. Chasing her 5 yards this way, that way.
Now it's time to make a plan. We don't know where this bugger's gonna bed down. We have to do it right, take our time. We're probably only gonna get one chance at it.
I don't know what you just said. I don't know.
What's our plan then?
Well, I gotta see where they get to where they'll bed, mm-hmm. and see if it's a stockable deal. I mean, the nice thing, you know where he's at.
Mm-hmm. So, right.
It's time to go, it's time to go, and then other times you gotta like just...
I tell you, if we knew for sure my gun was coming, it'd be just let him sit.
Times you gotta like just... decide.
With so much at stake, Bo and John don't want to risk the shot with a borrowed gun.
Hey, Cole, find out if Babasho picked up his rifle this morning. In America, they say yes, come to Dushanbe today. So call Babasho, see if the rifle came. I don't speak Russian or Tajik. No answer. This morning they said, not tonight. This morning the flight came from America. So someone needs to call him and see if the rifle will be here. We shoot and make, it's not his gun. He shoots, we have a problem, and then we get back to camp and his rifle's in camp. I would be very upset. If his rifle is coming, get the rifle here.
Sometimes coordinating with the locals is really difficult. We have to work it out, figure out how to get it done if we're going to continue to work in this area. So that's one of the challenges. I'm confident we're going to get John within shot range of a Markhor. I just hope his own rifle gets here or is en route.
In Zimbabwe, after missing on two zebra, Rob Dunham and the team have returned to base camp, where Rob has a plan to try and rebuild his client Kirk's confidence.
Kirk is resighting his gun in. He was having some trouble with it because we missed earlier. If it's off, you want to know so your confidence isn't screwed up. Made a nice target.
Well, this is the only time I hope it is off a little bit. Otherwise, I was shooting through him.
Let's try it.
We set up a 6-inch target about 50 yards away. That's gonna tell us if it's the hunter or the gun.
Watch your ears. Hit the tree.
That should be good. We're hoping. No, I bet you, it should, from dead center, it should be an inch right on the edge of the blaze.
Oh no, inch to the left. pinch to the left.
No, no. Oh, it hit here.
Yeah, I thought.
Okay, I was holding right there. So it is shooting to the left.
Yeah. Well, because that's not bad at 50 yards, but it's amplified at 100 and.
Well, it's double everything.
We'll do one more. If we can get it to touch the blaze, we'll leave it.
Well, like I said, I was pretty well dead center.
This is a relief. Gear, we can fix. But a hunter who's doubting himself and his confidence is gone, that's a hell of a lot harder to correct.
That was bang dead center. That should be good. We're hoping.
Same side, left side is good.
Yeah.
But it's shooting to the left, so move it a couple clicks to the right.
Go straight dead.
Yeah. We'll remind them. When the elephant is charging, hey, just relax and just pull 2 inches to the right. Kurt, up and down is perfect. But you are to the left 1.5 inches.
Okay.
I mean, that's a lot. I mean, I was.
You're shooting 200 yards. You could be out a lot.
I'll be out like I was right there. I'm out.
Be out like you'd be out just like you'd be like on a like a zebra.
True Magnum TV is brought to you by TrueMagnum.com.
In Utah, the bull James has been following all week is now just 100 yards in front of him, but the sun is setting.
I reckon if we can just get to him in time, huh? Man, 50 more minutes of light. Boy, they're just not giving us much of a chance these days, huh?
Well, it's just a matter of time now, but unfortunately, that's the one thing we no longer have on our side. If we can get in the right position right now, this is a done deal. That's the little one. The big one's behind him.
This late in the day, spotting the target is more difficult, along with judging distance.
There's no coming now. We gotta get around this little guy. We should get to that next tree. Brady cow call from back there. We're all set up in this next opening. If we can cut him on that ridge, we got him. We gotta cut him off. Got him in here. Oh, Dunham. Yeah. Okay. Nope. Oh, stupid knee. I just gotta get it straight. Oh. All right, that's it. That's it. That's it. That's over.
What happened? Wanna go grab Brady? Let's get out of here.
Next time on True Magnum TV, can Rob Dunham's hunting client shake the zebra jinx?
This female's rebuck's gonna screw us up, though.
Is James Bryant's mountain hunting career over? Or will he bounce back? And with a borrowed gun, will Bo Morgan's hunter connect on a possible world record Markhor?
It looks pretty good, except there's a bush in front.
You're all solid.
All right.